Okay, what you're looking at here is just the box, actually, but it's the box that my newest tool came in, the Central Pneumatic Air Palm Nailer. I got it from Harbor Freight for under 30 bucks. I think I paid 22, maybe 29 bucks, something like that. I don't know, but it was under 30 with tax, and it's item number 68027, 68027. Easily drives nails in tight places. Lightweight aluminum body. Actually, the thing's pretty heavy, but I like it that way. I don't like things that are too light. And this is my first time using it. Actually, it's not the first time. I did try it somewhere else on the aluminum before, just once, and it worked. So at any rate, today we're using this to cover up, to nail in little pieces of trim to go across these little spaces here in between the windows and there. And what I'm doing is I've learned by playing with it. And you do want to you want to test a new tool out before you actually use it on your work. You want to play with it a little bit, and definitely always read the instructions and follow them. If instructions were not needed for these, for tools and things like this, they wouldn't bother printing them. So you want to read the instructions. You want to oil it properly and keep it clean. It is an air tool, and all air tools are like that. You also want to, you know, play with it with different pressures of air, because this thing will, it'll really go nuts on 120 pounds of pressure. I've got it down to 60 for this. I played with it outside and tested it, and then I came in here and tried one, and 60 pounds is perfect for this purpose. So what we're going to do here, I'm going to show you. I'm going to throw all my hammers away. I'll tell you, I've been a carpenter for a long time, and this thing is neat. I mean, you know, they have the great big, you know, nailers, but how do you, you know, but those are for chain nailing. How do you use one of those for one of these twisty nails? These twisty nails have always been a big pain in the butt, especially if you're nailing into the walls or the ceiling, because the ceiling and the walls want to bounce back at you, so it makes it very hard to nail. So watch this. You're not going to believe it. Let's see. Can you see? Yeah, okay, you can see. This is just a, oops. See why it's so hard to do camera work in the trailer? Somebody was yelling at me the other day to put my camera on a tripod in the trailer because they were getting motion sickness. I'm sorry about that, but it's tight quarters in here, and you can't always use a tripod, and I got to get this trailer finished. I don't have time for nonsense. But watch this. Here it is. It comes with a leather, well, some kind of cover on it to keep dust out and stuff. And it fits right in the palm of your hand. And it has this thing here. See, there's the actual hammer right inside there. Okay. And watch how easy this is. Now, I put the nail in the little hole that I drilled, which is just a little bit smaller than the nail itself. This one actually goes up here. Yeah, okay. We do want everything to be perfect. And again, you're seeing why it's so hard for me to have a camera inside the trailer while I'm working. But anyway, I'll try and get out of the way so you can see this. See how well it works. That's it. You just push, and it nails that thing in that easily. Okay, we'll do another one now, and I'll try and do it from a different angle. Maybe you can see it better, because I can't really tell if it... Ow! Alright, so we're a little more zoomed in now. So I just take the piece of wood that I already have. This is just paneling that I ripped down to 1 inch. And I'll center it over everything, and I'll just make a little line right there. And I'll go outside and cut it using my hand miter box, the little hand one, not an electric. You can use an electric one if you got one. Okay, I'm going to cut this, drill the hole, put the little nail in it, and we'll see the palm nailer in action again. These are pre-stained. I already shellacked these so that I could just cut the bits and pieces. And now I'm trying to get over here out of the way. Okay, so what we do is I drill the hole, I put the little twisty nail in there, and that'll hold it. I'm gonna grab the palm nailer and try not to knock the camera over and not to hurt anything else in the trailer. And boy, did this used to be a pain in the butt with a hammer, because like I said, this stuff would bounce back at you. Okay, I'm gonna try and get me out of the way as much as possible to get the nail straight. Okay, and then we just push on it. I mean, that's neat, folks. That is really neat. I think it needs one more hit because the nail's not quite in far enough. There. Boy, I mean, this thing is strong, too. It does the job. So that's at 60 pounds. You could even lighten it up a little bit if you did, you know, if you wanted to. But that's at 60 pounds. So isn't that cool? Now, I could have had all these done at the time it took me to do this one on... for these two on video. I could have had everything in the trailer done by now, but anyway, I just wanted to show you that. Really neat tool. Again, another great tool from Harbor Freight. I love Harbor Freight. Too bad they don't sell lumber and all the other stuff we need, because I'd go to them way before I'd go to Home Depot, that's for sure.